For some reason, former Vice President Mike Pence thought it would be a good idea to go on ABC this weekend on This Week with host Jonathan Karl. And of course, he was asked about the pending indictment against Donald Trump that may or may not be coming tomorrow. And Mike Pence tried to distance himself from that Stormy Daniels scandal by saying that, hey, I wasn't even a part of the administration when it happened. To which Jonathan Karl had to call him out to his face to point out that, yeah, you were. And then Mike Pence, of course, tried to dance around the issue. So here is Mike Pence basically getting called a liar to his face by ABC's Jonathan Karl. Take a look.
But you say he's a former president possibly about to be indicted, and it's unprecedented. Aren't his actions unprecedented? I mean, we never saw a presidential candidate give $130,000 to a porn star to keep her from talking. I mean, these are unprecedented actions.
Well, John, as you know, those events transpired before I even joined the national ticket, and so I can't speak to the merits of the case.
Well, the payoff happened just 2 weeks before the election.
But I can't speak to the merits of the case. Yeah. And in America, you're innocent until proven guilty. That's not always true in the national media, but it is true in our justice system. And look, I know that President Trump can take care of himself. Yeah. And this process will play out if, in fact, an indictment comes down.
So I want to ask you about your...
Yeah, I mean, that was way, way, way before Pence came along. And yeah, I mean, I wasn't even there. it was 2 weeks before the election, sir. Well, you know, I mean, I can't speak to the merits of the case. I'm not exactly sure what happened there. No, you just flat out lied. You got called on your lie. Like, you could have said, like, oh, wow, I didn't realize that because I know so little about it because I was not privy to any of that. That's how you should have handled that. You should have acted shocked. Like, even if it was just pretending, because I know you know what happened. We all know that you know what happened. But all you had to do, Mike, was sit there and be like, 2 weeks? Wow. I had actually thought it happened long before that. I was unaware. Oh my God, that kind of changes things a little bit. I wasn't associated with it. Like, that's all you had to do. Even if you knew in your head it was a lie, you wouldn't have gotten called out to your face for continuing to dance around the issue and acting like, well, blah, 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 blah. No. You're an idiot. And of course, you have no chance at becoming president, even if you are running for president, which you haven't announced, but you kind of keep doing things that make it seem like you're running for president. But you're an idiot, and you've pretty much alienated the entire Republican base. Like, the MAGA people are never going to vote for you, so you have no chance of winning a primary. And because of that, you'll never become the nominee. Those are the same people walking around chanting, hang Mike Pence during the insurrection. And you cannot win a Republican primary without some bleed over between either the MAGA to the normals or the normals to the MAGA. And right now, you don't seem to really have either, because you've got the stench of Trump on you. And if he gets indicted, yeah, that is going to hurt you, Mike Pence, even though you weren't involved. And then, of course, you've got the MAGA freaks who hate you because you wouldn't break the law to help Donald Trump stay in office. So, yeah, you're kind of old news. So you've got nothing to lose at this point. Why are you even trying to cape for Donald Trump? Go ahead, throw him under the bus, man. At this point, it can only help you as you move forward with your pathetic little campaign. If you can't get enough Ring of Fire, we encourage everyone to subscribe to our channel for fresh video content 7 days a week. And for even more from me, you can follow me on all social media outlets, Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Farron Balanced.